winter in the heart of Alaska. It's cold. The average high is just 3 degrees. Alaska's Eielson Air Force Base is strategically located, but not exactly on the grid. And it takes more than jet fuel to power this base. Without electricity, these planes don't fly. Right now, the base relies on coal to power its operations. But it's been chosen to demonstrate a next-generation micro-reactor. These are not your grandfather's reactors. They're safe and small enough that the whole system can be transported off-base at the conclusion of the pilot project. Eielson was picked because of an increased need for resilient power sources to house and operate its growing fleet, including the combat-ready 354th Fighter Wing F-35s and the Air National Guard's 168th Wing KC-135 Stratotankers, aircraft that are the first line of defense for the Northwest. As the nation's largest single energy consumer, the U.S. military needs a lot of electricity for power, and power requirements are growing. Nowhere are they more critical than at our remote bases. So Congress has directed the Department of Defense to site and operate at least one nuclear reactor at a DoD facility within a decade to meet energy resilience and assurance needs. At Eielson, a commercial vendor will license, own, and run the micro-reactor, and the base will purchase the power it produces. Not only could a micro-reactor increase the resiliency of base operations, but it is a clean source of energy as well. Alaskans will soon have the chance to learn more about this project, which may provide the Air Force with an option for reliable, safe, carbon pollution-free power production that could be deployed at other DoD installations.